Share with us how and why you got involved in the dissemination of behavior science and why you think it's important.
That I feel like, actually, when I came into BDA, we shared a very similar vision, and that is, you know, expanding the world's collective vision. This was Brett's words about I loved it, so that it's being you can be used everywhere. I say it is the greatest science in the world because, case in point, what science can improve other sciences by improving the respective performance of the scientists, right? So it's a great science, people misunderstand it, and we just have to, one of the things that we engage in is like storytelling. There's a great book out about, you know, science needs storytelling, and they do, because we need to get people to look at the science first, right? Say, well, I need this, you know? I need this in my life, and everybody needs the basic principles of human behavior in their life to help themselves become better and help others become better. And I think I see a lot of people nodding your heads out there. It's true, right? But we have to be better at marketing and disseminating. And disseminating isn't just about sharing. Disseminating is getting people to adopt these principles.
When it comes to dissemination, have you guys, raise your hand if you've seen some of the movement of adults that are on the autism spectrum saying that it's traumatic and that they really dislike ABA? Okay. And these folks, at first, I was a little angry. This is some years ago when I would see it. And then later, the compassion kicked in and I started realizing when I was reading the comments of individuals that are on the autism spectrum that said they were facing trauma and a history of challenges, I would respond as much as I could to a comment that way about how damaging behavior science has been. Well, medicine was damaging in the early years. I mean, still can be, right? So every technology, teaching technology, medicine, science, it evolves. Yes, maybe for sure, there were many faults of the science. Another thing I would just ask is that we do collectively as a practice is for us to explain to best we can and model the fact that the science is intended to help people meet their own goals, not for control, not for manipulation, and not for other people's own gain, like it ties back to earlier. So the science should be to help people meet their goals, obviously if they're healthy goals.